What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's Dan here. Welcome back to PGA Tour 2K21 career. Moving on to the next challenge now, which is the Northern Trust at TPC Boston. We are in the playoffs for the PGA Championship. Now, as you can see, there's only three events, including the Tour Championship, and these next events are worth 2,000 FedEx Cups, FedEx Cup points. I always do that, FedEx Cups. They're worth 2,000 of those FedEx Cups. Trade it. See how much they're worth. No, they're worth 2,000 FedEx Cup points, which is quite a doozy. So it's gonna be exciting, man. This is where I've really gotta bring it, though. I can't be making mistakes because JT can win a couple of these and pass me, and then I'm out of the tournament. You know what I mean? And I lose. But all I know is I have enough points that I should be able to make to the Tour Championship, but I'm not gonna sleep on D. I'm gonna make sure I do all I can to save it. So, Northern Trust, before we jump in, though, we do actually have a new outfit, a new shirt we unlocked. So we're going to go back to that, those ways. We're going to make it, it's a red shirt, brand new red shirt. Gotta love those polos. It's a bronze, but so is this. At least it's nicer out, you know what I'm saying? So now we look like we're ready to win. I'm ready to win. So, wait, do I still have my sponsor, or is my sponsorship done? Oops, one thing I forgot to do, I just realized. I tend to forget this whenever I go out and play it, but got a copy pasta. Bam. I think for the Tour Championship, I'm gonna pick my own outfit, you know? We'll see, but in order to get the last sponsorship, I need to place top three in this event. So let's not disappoint, and let's bring it home. Let's do it.
2K Sports, in association with the PGA Tour, is proud to bring you the first stop of the FedEx Cup playoffs. Today's coverage of the Northern Trust is about to begin. Hi, I'm Luke Olvey alongside Rich Beam, and we find ourselves in the northeast of the country in beautiful Norton, Massachusetts. In fact, not far from where Tom Brady has helped the Patriots win 6 Super Bowl titles, and we're at the beautiful TPC Boston. This is a great golf course, redesigned by Gil Hans.
It was originally by Arnold Palmer, redesigned by Gil Hans in 2007. And it's a big golf course, meaning it takes up a lot of the property. And it's one of those golf courses.
All right, so we got a happy tailwind here.
Making birdies, but they're not that easy to come by. There's a bunch of holes out there where you get into a difficult stretch of the golf
course. That's clean, actually. That is beautiful. We almost greened it with one shot, boys and girls.
Where you're really just kind of
hanging
your life. But all in all, it's
that is a phenomenal shot.
To make some birdies.
To be fair, we did have a chance.
Who's actually striking the ball the best? It's not so much a putting contest usually at TPC Boston as it is a ball striker's paradise. So I think you're going to see the ball strikers, or the better ball strikers.
Oh! That was almost an eagle, ladies and gentlemen.
Of course, or bombs away.
It's both. I don't think it really suits one or the other. But
they're still yapping.
I'm going with the bombers.
I know I can't wait. Let's get back down to the coverage.
Well, that's a lovely way to get going. They've already started.
It's a shame I didn't get that chip in for eagle right off the first tee.
I can't ever recall
him
making a birdie and feeling bad about it. So yes, birdie on the first, great job.
That is horrid. I felt that. I don't even want to know. Hit someone in the face. Jesus H. I just wanted to fast forward that.
Tony Finau just a short time ago.
See, it's whenever you pause, that's how you know.
He's a sharp shooter from short range, isn't he? Yes, it's in.
I don't care about how good Tony Finau is right now.
There's been plenty of talk about the prototype.
This is a par 5. It seems I always mess up the par 5s, eh?
Well, Tony Finau, he fits the bill, doesn't he?
He's got a swing that is unique to himself. Very short, compact, and yet so powerful. When he puts it all together, he is a contender each and every week.
Especially the big ones. Uncanny how often he's up there in the
All
ranges.
Right, let's see if we can
he's
get it.
He's got a mind that is so strong with self-belief, and that's exactly what is needed for those big events.
I'm hoping that's not too much. The wind is kind of preventing that. Hopefully a little bounce left. No. As you can see, we're going to be going uphill on this next one.
Attaboy. Good shot. And this putt is for a big four on the scorecard.
Ooh, that is a close one. Come on, Dano. That might have been too much.
Looking
nope.
Really
beautiful.
Good. The putt drops. Woo. That's back-to-back birdies.
I like it. Two in a row. He's feeling it.
That was an important shot.
Threes are always fun.
Considering I messed it up.
par three for the back tee measures 208 yards, a split.
Beautiful shot. I'm hoping I nailed the timing.
To make birdie twos, but par threes should be had.
Oh, that is too much.
Anywhere up on that dance floor would be nice.
Oh, that is not good. But
this should be a momentum saver here, getting this up and down.
Oh, you little.
Oh, went in the hole.
Man, that is always a specific. That just sucks.
Okay, let's head to the next. Currently a couple under.
That should have been a chip in, but whatever. I'll take the par.
Boston Rich, a great short par four.
Driver,
par four,
hey.
Measures 298 yards from the back tee. Players looking to.
I'm doing this in hopes that I can skip the bunker, but it looks like. Oh, wait a minute. I might split it nicely. Oh,
sure.
I was worried I was going to hit this bunker up ahead here. That is a great approach.
And now Intrepid on course reporter, John standing by.
I'll be following Kevin Kisner. We're on the sixth for his next shot.
It's funny, it's not as special when they don't show.
Okay, let's get back to the action.
You know, them actually sinking it.
Here at the fourth.
Oh, yes. Man.
Well, that was like a laser straight at it. And a chance for a spot in the top 20 of the leaderboard if he can make
solid
this.
Approach, but yeah, wasn't enough to do the dance.
And that will take him to 3-under.
3-under par.
Our current leader is enjoying a 2-stroke lead.
It's a par 4, which is interesting. That felt really rubbish, but it was actually good. It felt like I slipped it, but I think that's money right in the bag.
Lining up from around 160 yards.
Seemed a little fast.
The seven.
It's like hitting like a ton of bricks. It'll green it, but that's going to be a tough one to hold from there.
That's tiny.
John, give us a small update.
Down here on the sixth as Tony Finau gets ready for his next shot.
Oh, what a great stroke.
Jesus.
It doesn't matter how you hit it if you can hold putts like that. Let's get back to it, shall we? Well, good chance to take it even deeper here. This putt's for 4-under.
Slightly up, it'll straighten out right as it gets up, though. Ooh. I'm hoping that. Oh, I underdid it a bit. And it still was too much. Man, that's a shame.
On this one.
That should have dropped. There's two holes that should have. Three holes that should have dropped.
Time to tee off at the sixth.
Par four, 465 yards from the back tee, bunkers down the
that's
right
fast.
Side
I felt that.
Nuisance.
But it should be fine.
Fronting the left part of the green.
It'll probably bounce a little to the left, to be honest.
If players find the fairway off their tee shots. Second shot to a very flat green. You can get it close, but still difficult on this long par four.
Game with the 9-iron, I think.
Looking pretty good, actually. Bounce left. Oh my God, please drop. It's going to miss.
Oh, that's great.
That's how it always
just
is, man.
The hole.
That would have been a sexy eagle.
Well played. A chance for birdie.
I honestly thought that was going down, but I'll take the birdie.
That's birdie number four today. That's a good way to move into the top 10. Now seven shots behind.
Man, I got to get one of those chip-ins, really. Just give me that edge.
Favors the brave. Plenty of bravery here. Out comes the driver.
Par five that measures
fast, but that should level it out, I think. The wind kept it. I'm just hoping it doesn't bounce right. Should bounce left, though. Yeah.
Make a decision. Do I go over the large bunker 100 yards away, or do I lay back at it? Either way, you must make a par five here, because birdies will be had by the big hitters.
That's fast, but it should straighten myself out. I should hit. It'll bounce into the fairway. Clean. That's a big par five, man.
You like that, didn't you?
To be fair, I think the wind kind of hindered me a little bit, but we got a pitch, so I'm gonna do a slight adjustment. It's perfect. Actually, the wind wasn't enough. I could have done it more to the left.
This putt for inside the top five on the leaderboard.
For the birds.
And
beautiful.
Up their fifth birdie of the day. And that will take him to five under. Well, there's action aplenty all over the course. Let's have a look at this highlight from another player.
And this is a great opportunity, a great look from long range.
Ah, not enough.
Next putt is short and sweet, just like you like it.
So after that hole, this is the current standings on the course. Our leader is enjoying a three-stroke advantage. And after a birdie at the last, they take the honor on the hole.
Par 3 measures 213 yards and a diabolical green, to say the least. The left-hand side sits much higher than the right-hand side, and the green is usually very firm. A tough ask.
Well,
just a little work.
That looks nice. I think I landed right where I needed to. Just a little further.
You're a ball striker. There's no doubt about that.
The iron play today has been absolutely stellar. Luke, the greens in regulation, just a fantastic accomplishment. Great to watch.
Ooh, I thought that one was
clean. Another miss, hey?
Lovely touch. Well played.
Judging it beautifully.
And as they stand over this putt, it's for a share of third spot.
Oh, wow. Okay. Hoping that'll do it. It does kind of wiggle back. It looks, it barely changed.
Putting for par.
That's rude, man.
Job done. Let's head to the next. And a little slide down the leaderboard happening. Make sure you respond quickly. We have a par four on this one.
Ninth hole, par four, 472 yards from the
beautiful
back tee.
Can't go wrong with that shot.
Will not come into play. And this green sits below the players on their second shot. We have seen birdies made here in the past, but they are really difficult to come by.
Currently minus five, time for fifth.
I'm gonna have to bounce it in a little.
Going with the eight iron here.
That's clean, that might bounce pretty close. Oh man, how many times is that gonna happen? Because it was landing,
to move into third place.
That would, if I was on the hole, that would have gone in, 100%. Hoping that'll do it.
Hey, nice looking line.
Oh, close.
Mark it down. That's
almost not enough.
Today. And that will take him to six under. He currently sits in third position.
Still got work to do, man. 11 under for Henrik.
Let's see what happens here.
Henrik.
At the 10th hole.
Par four, just 425 yards on the card, but this hole plays so
beautiful.
Much more difficult than the yardage. Water to the left of the green, bunkers surrounding it on both sides. Find the
clean
fairway,
drive.
Have a good look at making birdie. You miss the fairway, good luck. Fours, fives, and sixes come into the equation.
It's a pitch, so it's almost like that might actually be money.
Choosing the 9-iron here.
Hoping for a solid bounce up. Well, I'm on the green, and the approach is actually very solid.
That's an absolute ripper. What a shot.
And this one for back-to-back birdies.
That is crisp.
Ooh, nice line. Fair effort, that. Good birdie.
Having a great day so far.
To 7-under. And as the scorecard suggests, heading up the leaderboard. And we've arrived at a par three.
Par three measures 231 yards from the back. A very difficult test indeed. A long green that is unforgiving.
I'm doing the hybrid because I want to counteract the wind. And even that, they suggested a five wood. As you could see, that was still too much.
Wonderfully played.
Let's go to our man John on the ground. There's something brewing down there. Let's find out what it is.
I'm down here following Tony Fina on the 12th hole.
Oh, that one just missed the hole. Well, that's a beautiful bunker shot there. This one's for birdie.
Their yeah, it's a dicey one.
It's been absolutely sublime, fun to watch.
Hoping for the best. That's looking pretty crisp. It's going to miss. Damn it.
A bit long on that one.
That was a rough green.
Remaining to the cup. That's half a chance of being home.
I'll take the par, though.
Ooh, that looks like a pure stroke. And staying right where they were in today's rankings after that.
I got to move up, though. I have seven more, and I got to pass Henry. It's enough time to do it, but...
Par 4, 510 yards. It is a brute. Those bunkers.
Beautiful. Am I going to... Do you think I'm going to be safe on the fairway, or am I going to have to hit that little crappy part?
A big, deep...
Oh, that's perfect. No, stop. That's money. I'd rather not. I'd rather make the fairway, but...
All in all, just a tough hole, to say the least.
Let's recap the action from just some moments ago. Ian Poulter with an outstanding shot here.
I gotta say, I'm glad we got another look. That is in there close.
Time for the second shot at the 12th.
Small amount. That actually is pretty clean, man.
Great looking shot, this.
I'm hoping it's too fast. That's too bad. Way too fast.
Yeah, nicely played. Chance to move to 8 under here.
Pretty smooth, though. That might have been too much. What happened?
3 feet to go here today.
That does suck. Save it, though, for par. We're just not going to make any gains, right?
And he finds himself in a tie for third.
Sung just passed me.
Leaderboard, Luke,
but he's 17 done.
Thing.
I have six more holes. It's still possible.
Par four. Step up to the tee and own it.
Par four, 447
perfect.
Yards. Tee shot.
That is gorgeous.
Up the hill to a blind landing area. Second shot is to a green that is surrounded by a cavern of bunkers. If you miss all those and find the green in two, then you'll have a decent look at a birdie three.
Getting ready to play their third.
Dude, if he sinks that. My then God.
That'll be for birdie.
What a play from the rough. Was hoping to get on the green and does one better.
That's pretty crisp.
The 9-9.
Could have done it a little more to the left, but well, that wind was strong enough to keep me. I'm on the green at least. Actually within decent shots.
A wonderful shot. A chance for birdie here on the 13th. Trying to get to 8 under par with this putt. This one's dialed in.
Beautiful.
And that's 8 birdies today. Oof. And with that, we'll move to 8 under par. Awesome play.
Gotta keep them birdies coming, boys and girls.
Is up by 3 shots.
Managing.
But they're done. Who else is done?
The leaders. Close.
Where is JT?
Gotta like it.
I want to get this win and get this that 2K.
One of the more difficult holes in golf. The long par 4.
Par 4 from the
felt bad, but the wind might have helped me there, actually. I kind of swooped it. You see what I mean? Look at that release on the right. But
down the hill,
I ended up catching a mulligan.
We'll have a decent look at finding the green in two, but I got to say it is a difficult par 4, and you'd be happy to walk away with that score.
The 14th hole at TPC Boston is a par 5.
A little faster,
for the
but I'm
converted par 4 for the
I'm worried about that
ridge,
bunker.
And it's a strong second shot.
No, we're okay with the bunker.
Second shot,
too
very
far.
Narrow opening to this
oof,
green.
That's bad.
If you miss it out to the right in the bunkers, you have a difficult time getting it up and down. Out to the left, you have some options. Pars can be made.
Oh, yes.
That was a big time save.
Whoa.
Nothing like it.
Good what a chip. Stuff. I wasn't sure if that was going to go down or not, but that had to happen.
That shot.
That one was one of those ones that gravity just took over. Oh, man. Right at the cusp. That's beautiful.
Just 2 shots back after that hole.
And we still have, we still have 4 more to go.
Closer to that top spot on the leaderboard. Things are definitely heating up.
So those guys, he's finished his day, so...
Par 4, and a fun little par 4 at that.
I needed that. That was perfect. The wind will slow me down, and I'll land safely on the fairway.
Green that can provide some entertainment as there's some different swales in the green, and your golf ball can go a-wandering if you're not careful. John, what's going on out there?
I'm down on the 17th hole, and this is Kevin Kisner's next shot.
Go in. And he holds it.
What a putt. And with that, we'll move to 5-under par.
Well, he's still not that high up.
Second shot here on the 15th.
Actually, I wonder if I should gap wedge it and use the wind. It's fast, but I think the wind will push me back.
This one looks like it'll safely make the green.
Pretty clean, man. That's what I wanted. But if I wasn't fast, I would have been right on top of it.
9 feet left to the hole.
Just a small curvature. That should do it.
It's tracking.
Give me that money.
And that's for birdie.
Just be thankful you're getting it this close right now.
Dig deep to pull this one out. Let's see what they got.
Guys, three more.
Sitting at 10 under par for the day.
Well, now, those guys are all done. Third, fourth, they're all done. So it's my race to lose at this point.
Here we are in front of a par three.
Par three, just 161 yards from the back. However, watch out for this green. There's a large shelf on the right
hand side. This is going to be tough.
If it's up there, good luck getting it close. And whatever you do, don't be silly and hit it left in the water. That's just a bad shot.
What I did was hit the fairway. But I think that's okay because...
And what a rare miss today. They've been so good with their approach shots.
And what do you call that?
Oh, Rich, how good is that? And that'll promote a good...
That's beautiful. Man, I'm stoked about
that. It's time to recap that play.
Why I'm stoked about that? Because it was a better position than that other side of the green where I had to hit it uphill. I preferred taking it from that chipping range because I knew I could. It was flush. We were already up on the shelf. I'd rather overshoot it off the green on the shelf than hit the green under the shelf. Does that make sense? Anyway, two more holes. We are tied at first.
17, par 4, 412 yards, dogleg from right to left. Second shot is down the slope.
That's really slow.
Lots of bunkers on this hole.
Ooh, I'm clearing it. And find the... Don't hit bunker, please.
Then
hit bunker.
On your mind.
But to be honest, man, I'm okay with this sand trap.
Not really what they were hoping for there.
In the bunker, off the tee, got to make up for a mistake.
Oh dear, I just realized. How far can I splash? Nope, reset the shot. Lob wedge. See, that's going to be... I got a wind ahead of me. Do you see my problem? Actually, the sand wedge is a better choice here. I mean, you might as well use the sand wedge in the sand. Actually, I could have backed off more.
Nicely
this is
done.
For birds. That is as flush as it can get. That should go right in.
Looking better.
Beautiful, man.
That's well hold.
Now we're in the lead. Now again, it's my tournament to lose.
John, give us an update. What's shaking?
We're on the 18th now, guys. This is Ian Poulter's next shot.
And here we are with the third shot.
Well, he is in fourth place. He's tied for fourth. He finishes dead in 8-under. Now, if I get a bogey, I lost.
The field is shaping up.
I don't see JT in this one.
A one-shot lead.
So it's a par 5.
Continues to grow.
This is actually ideal.
Simply amazing.
That is so good. It's going to slow me down, so it should stop before it gets into that little sketchy bit there. This is a long shot to make, though. I know it's a par 5, but damn, you know. I think I can make green from here. That is going to slow us down a fair margin. And I hit perfectly. Slow up, slow up, slow up. Bounce left, please. Bounce left. Yes. Oh my. That you can't get much better than that.
That's right out of the copybooks. Exquisite.
Bro.
Lining up here.
Give me that eagle.
To win the tournament.
Bam. Just to make it a little bit tougher on him. 14 under. Finishing with an eagle. That's a good sign. That's 2,000 FedEx Cup points.
Yes, good victory.
That was an important win.
Boston, great week all around.
What a great course, man. I had a good time with this one.
However, you could only have one winner, and this player rose and shone above the rest.
I love that.
Stepping up at the right time, Rich. Getting a victory in the FedEx Cup playoffs.
This is where it pays to perform. FedEx Cup wins, playoff wins, massive.
Look at that bad boy.
Good job.
Well, on behalf of myself, Rich Beam and all the
I'll bet Hendrick is pretty salty. Thanks for tuning Justin in. Finished we'll seventh. He didn't have that great of a day. Normally, it's him I gotta watch for. Almost at the 25th level. Tony, I beat him on all of those, so it's gonna take two more at least. So by the time in a perfect world, by the time we're done this game, I'll have Tony Finau done and dealt with. Is that enough? We leveled up. New clubs. We got new fairway drivers. That is awesome. What a great timing for that, hey? All right, so what we're going to be doing is checking out our clubs. And I'm going to keep going with them. Is this a 5-wood? It's better forgiveness. I'd say that makes sense. 5-wood. And this is a 3-wood. I'd say the positives make up for the negatives. Now we just need that driver. Probably not going to have the same distance, but it's going to be better, more controllable. So I'm ready for this next one. I'll save the sponsor for the next video, though. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, that'll be it for this one. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, do me a favor, hit that like button. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you haven't yet, be sure to like and follow my pages on social media, facebook.com/DanQ8000, Twitter at DanQ8000, Instagram at DanQ8000, and Snapchat DanQ8000. If you want to join my Discord server, there's an invite link in the description. If you want to get a shirt or hoodie, link in the description as well. If you want to save 10% of your next DXRacer, link in the description. Be sure to use the promo code DanQ8000 at checkout. Also, if you're shopping on the Epic Games Store, be sure to use my creator code DanQ8K. Finally, guys, if you want to sign up, become a DanQ8000 member, link in the description. Also, a join button below the video. If you sign up for that, you do get exclusive perks such as badges by your name, emojis to use in chat, exclusive videos and streams, and of course, the monthly game giveaway you'll be entered in. It does help out the page a lot, and I greatly appreciate it. All right, guys, thank you so much again. Take care. Have a great day. Be seeing you soon for more. But until then, let's hand things over to Knox Hill. Have a good one, guys. Who the man with the plan? If you feel trouble, wild and wild, no need violent and hit you 8,000. Wait a minute, hold that stylist dial. Damn, goddamn Billy Jack, we still riding, tires flat. I hear them sirens, see shots flying, so we driving fire back. If they ain't vibing, lie with that. Got me dressed up in all black. What up? Hood up, and I see them haters try to run with us. They don't need inhalers, gotta breathe them hard, just like Darth Vader. Players, grab your respirators. Night invaders get lightsabered. Mask on for the shooters, move like trash to bed intruder. Got that Glock and got them woofers. Just press play, I'll keep it moving. Who is Knox Hill, you damn fools? Keep it fresh like canned food. There ain't nothing we can't do, so tune into that dang Q. Yeah. It was never, ever a game.